for your glory, even to this point. We pray, Lord, from this point on, we'll go higher in Jesus' name. We reach farther in Jesus' name. And we pray that you deal with every one of us as your beloved, special, favorite child in Jesus' name. Help us today to take in your word and to pray through your word and then to have the benefit of your word in Jesus' name. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Welcome into Leviticus chapter 26. And I'm reading from verse 10. Leviticus chapter 26, verse 10. And ye shall eat old store and bring forth the old because of the new. Somebody shout amen. You notice two words there, the old and the new. And here is the promise of the Lord. Here is the provision of the Lord. Here is the prophetic utterance of the Lord, that he shall eat the old store. You'll not forget the old store. You'll not cast out the old store. You'll not abandon the old store. And then it says, and bring forth the old. Then it says, because of the new. Here the Lord brings together the old and the new. You should understand, we're getting to the new year, but we don't abandon the old house where we've been living. We can renovate it, we can paint it, we can make it better, but we don't abandon the old house. We can renew it as we come to the new year. You understand? Here we carry our body around, the same body that we used and had in the old year, the same body we carry into the new year. Yes, we can make it healthier, happier, stronger, so that the new year will have the same old body, but will have a renewed strength. Here we are. The same family we have now. In the old year, we carry that same family to the new year. We can renew our covenant. We can renew our relationship. And we can make better provision for that family. Yet, it's still the same family that we carry to the new year. There are many people that have the wrong idea that all that we learned in the old year, all the consecrations were made in the old year, all the covenants were made in the old year, as we come to the new year, we abandon. And then we'll say we're starting afresh now. It is like we never had any conversion, never had any conviction, never had any consecration, never had any commitment. It's a new year now. That's wrong. The same conversion that we had in the old year, we carry to the new year. The same consecration we had in the old year, we carry to the new year. And the same commitment we had in the old year, we carry to the new year. We make it better, we make it higher, and we make it stronger, but it's still the same old commitment and consecration we carry into the new year. There are many people that make mistakes. And they say, you see the Old Testament, we can close that
He's up. My miracle child.
We can cancel that.
So how does your miracle child get cancer?
That. Let's rush and
how does that happen?
On to the New Testament. That's wrong.
Basically, intestinal.
The same God of the old. It is the same God of the new. And the same God that says, I am God, I change not. He brings us from the old, he brings us to the new. he may lift us higher, but we build on the foundation of the old, and we stand on the strength of the old, and we obey all the words that he has given us, coming from the old to the new. Come back to Leviticus chapter 26, reading from verse 10 again. It says, and you shall eat old store, and bring forth the old because of the new. Then it says, I will set my tabernacle among you. Amen. My soul shall not abhor you. I will walk among you. If you don't abandon the old for the new, if you don't forget the old covenant totally because of the new, if you don't forget your old relationship with the Lord because you are coming to a new year, then he says, I will walk among you. I will be your God, and ye shall be my people. Verse 13, I am the Lord your God, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt. It says that old land, I'm still that same God. The old familiar territory, I brought you out of that. I'm still the same God. It says, I am the Lord. I'm bringing you out of the old year. I'm taking you to the new year. And it says, I'm still that same God that brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, that ye should not be there but me. And I have broken the bands of your yoke. My yokes are broken. My fetters are broken. My oppression is taken away. It says, I have broken your yoke and make you go, tell me, upright. Make you go upright. The same feet we used in the last year, in the old year, walking in the way of God, walking in the path of righteousness, the same feet is going to be stronger, it's going to be steadier, and it's going to be faster. But the same old feet we had in walking uprightly, that same feet was still had. All the old things we had in every study, in every service, all those old things the Lord gave us, we carry them without losing them, and we go into the new year. The subject today is the new beneficiaries of the old inexhaustible provision. The new beneficiaries. Are they here today? New beneficiaries. I said, are they there today? What are they? New beneficiaries. New beneficiaries. Put down your hands. God bless you. I said, God bless you. The new beneficiaries of the old inexhaustible provision. Three things. Number one, believing the old promises for new pilgrims. They are old, those promises, as old as the Old Testament, as old as the Ancient of Days, the old promises, but for new pilgrims. Number two, bring in the old price for a new progress. Bring in the old price for a new progress. Point number three, benefiting from the old privileges as new peculiar people. Benefiting from the old privileges as new peculiar people. Number one, believing the old promises for new pilgrims. To start with, we need to understand the Old Testament people were referred to as pilgrims and strangers, and the New Testament people, the same thing. Old or new, we are pilgrims. We're walking this path. We're going from here to there. We're going from earth to eternity. We're going from this world to heaven. as it was with them that were called pilgrims, so it is with us, we're called pilgrims. Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 13, these all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and they confessed that they were in the Old Testament, strangers and pilgrims on the earth. Mark it down in your mind. Note it down on your paper. They were called strangers and pilgrims. Let's come to 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2. We're reading from verse 11. Dearly beloved, it's talking to New Testament believers now. It's talking to you, talking to me. He's talking to the people who refer to themselves that they're now in the new covenant. Look at what he says. He says, dearly beloved, I beseech you, as strangers and pilgrims. The same thing that was said about the old covenant people, strangers and pilgrims. The same thing he says about the new covenant people, strangers and pilgrims. Abstain from fleshly lusts which war against the soul. What were the Old Testament promises? The old promises that saw them through, those people of the past. How did they get through? How did they walk the narrow way? What was their strength? What was their support? What was the standard before them? What were the experiences they had that made them stand? Believing the old promises for new pilgrims. Isaiah chapter 45. Reading from verse 22. Isaiah chapter 45, verse 22. Look unto me, and be saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God, and there is none else. What carried them through? Salvation. Salvation from God. God alone. And they had to look away from their idols. Look away from their tradition. Look away from the past. And look unto him, because he is God. And there is none else that can save. That's Old Testament. What does it say in the New Testament? Acts chapter 4, verse 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. You notice that? It's saying, look unto Christ, is the only Savior. Look away from darkness. Look away from occultism. Look away from tradition. Look away from religion. Look away from every other thing. And look unto Jesus. Because there's no salvation in any other. In the old salvation, in the new salvation. Come to Exodus chapter 15. Exodus chapter 15 in the old. Verse 26. The promises of the old that follow us into the new. Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. And said, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight, and will give ear to his commandments, plural, and keep all his statutes, plural, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord. What does he do for you? that healeth thee. That's in the old. It says, we listen to his commandments. We obey his commandments. We walk in the paths of righteousness. He says, you know what I'm going to do for you? I will be your healer. I am the Lord that healeth thee. That's Old Testament. Come to the New Testament now. James chapter 5. James chapter 5. I'm reading here from verse 15. The prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. If he has committed sin, they shall be forgiven him. Confess your faults one to another and pray one for another. Tell me what then will happen. Tell me if you're opening your Bible with me, that ye may be healed. Stop there. Confess your faults when you're sick. When you're oppressed, when you have pain, wrecking, ruining, and making your body like rocks, and you don't know what to do, it says, think through. Sin and sickness are joined together. Sin and suffering are joined together. And if you find any sin that's a cause of this, confess your sin unto God, that he will forgive you. And then the person you have offended, confess your sin, your faults, one to another, and then pray one for another, that he may be healed. The healing is still dependent on hearing the word, accepting the word, keeping the word, obeying the word. You cannot say, now this is New Testament. God, heal me. I'm going to use the healing to serve the devil, but heal me anyhow. No, it says, sin no more, lest a worse sin come on thee. That's why it says, confess your faults one to another, that she may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And you see here an amen there. Let's look at Job chapter 5, verse 19. Job chapter 5, verse 19. He shall deliver thee in 6 troubles. Yea, in 7 there shall no evil touch thee. What is he there? What is she there? No evil will touch you. Evil eyes will not see you. Evil power will not cut your life down. Accidents will be far away from you. Disasters will be far away from you. Look at what it says in the old, that he will deliver us from 6 troubles, and then remember 7 is the number for completeness, for totality. Every form of evil, the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name. Let's come to the New Testament, 2 Timothy chapter 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 18. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work. That's for me. I said that's for me. Why don't you say it to yourself? The Lord shall deliver me from every evil work and preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. You see what the Lord is saying? It's in the old, it's in the new. And so, we who are New Testament pilgrims, we're taking those promises in the old, and we know that they are brought into the new. and we're not just abandoning everything of the old and saying we're settling for the new. I'm coming back to the Old Testament, 2 Chronicles chapter 1, 2 Chronicles chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 7, 2 Chronicles chapter 1, verse 7. In that night did God appear unto Solomon and said unto him, ask what I shall give thee. Ask what I shall give thee. Verse 10, give me now, somebody there, give me now wisdom and knowledge that I may go out and come in before these people. For who can judge this thy people that is so great? Understand here, the Lord gave him an open check and said, ask what you want. As you come to the new, what does it say? Ask and it shall be given you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. He's bringing the old to the new. And it says, everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Ask, and he asked for wisdom. Come to James chapter 1. James chapter 1. I'm looking at verse 5. James chapter 1, verse 5. If any of you lack wisdom, look at that. Old Testament, ask. And Solomon asked for wisdom. And God said, because you've asked for this, I'm going to give you this wisdom and knowledge, and I'm going to give you more. And we come to the New Testament, and it says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that give it to how many people? That give it to how many people? You're going to have greater wisdom today than when you came. That give it to all men liberally, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. I will have more wisdom, I will have more strength, I will have more knowledge, I will have. I will not be ignorant of the overcoming life. As you come into the new year, all the wisdom you need to overcome, the Lord will give you. All the knowledge you need to bring the enemy before your Christian life, to bring him down, you will have. And all the power, all the courage, all the strength, all the backbone you need to give you the strength to overcome in the new year, the Lord will give unto you in Jesus' name. Look at Psalm 57, old and then the new. Psalm 57. In Psalm 57, I'm reading from verse 2. Psalm 57, verse 2. I will cry unto God Most High, unto God that performeth, as we come to the new year, and then any challenge faces your life. You remember, that challenge is under the theme, the title, and the topic of all things. I'm looking at victorious people. I'm looking at conquering people. Nothing will drive you back from the way of victory, accomplishment, and success in the new year in Jesus' name. There is a God in heaven, and he performs all things for me. He will do it for you. Underline those words, all things for me. Matthew chapter 6. I'm reading from verse 33. Matthew chapter 6, The start is three. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. The same thing is said in the old, the same thing is said in the new. He performeth all things for me. And in the new, as we go into the new year, there'll be no failure in your life. As you pray, there'll be no disappointment. As you seek the Lord, you will find the Lord. All things. Perform in your life all things. Done in your life all things. God perform it for you in Jesus' name. Romans chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 32. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give me? You have it. It will be done. You'll carry a basket of blessings of all things. Of all things. I said of all things. Believing the old promises for new beggars. Point number two. Bringing the old price for a new progress. Bringing the old price for a new progress. There are many people that want to have progress. That's normal. That's legitimate. That's a good desire. But they don't connect price with progress. They think progress will just come. How did it happen? In the old, there is a price. In the new, there is a price. Let's come back to the old. Bring in the old price for a new progress. 2 Samuel chapter 24. 2 Samuel chapter 24. We're reading from verse 24. And the king said unto Arauna, nay, but I will surely be at a price. I want progress at a price. I want improvement at a price. I want achievement at a price. I want divine favor at a price. I want the plagues all to be totally erased, eradicated out of the nation at a price. You see, there are people, they say, and there's no price to that prayer. There's no self-denial to that prayer. And there is no giving something, giving that prayer. There is no absolute surrender to the King of Kings for that prayer. That's a superficial prayer, and it's not the key. It says, I will surely buy each of thee at a price. Offer burnt offering unto the Lord, my God, of that which does cost me nothing. Cost me nothing. Cost me. There are some people, and I hope our church does not become like them. They meet somebody, they say, speak a word in my life. They continue in their sin, speak a word in my life. They continue in their idolatry, speak a word in my life. They continue in their careless life in the presence of the Lord, speak a word in my life. Their religion cost them nothing. Their prayers cost them nothing. Their service cost them nothing. But here David said, I will buy it at a price, and I will not offer anything to the Lord that cost me nothing. So David bought the threshing floor and the oxen for 50 shekels of silver, and David built there an altar to the Lord and offered burnt offerings and peace offerings. So the Lord was entreated for the land, and the plague was staged for Israel. Price. The old price. If we're going to make new progress. Matthew chapter 13, New Testament now. Matthew chapter 13 is still the same. We're reading from verse 44 and verse 45. Matthew chapter 13, verse 44, again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto treasure hid in a field, which when a man has found, he hideth, and for joy thereof goeth and selleth all that he had and buyeth the field. He selleth all that he had and he buys the field. This is a man that knows if you're going to have treasure in the kingdom of God, there is a price to pay. In verse 45 again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a merchant man seeking goodly pearls. Verse 46, who when he had found one pearl of great price. Christianity is not cheap, of great price. Following the Lord is not cheap, of great price. Serving the Lord is not cheap, of great price. Having a place in the kingdom of God is not cheap, of great price. He went and sold all that he had, and he bought it. He bought it. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 6. I'm reading from verse 19. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? Look at this. For ye are bought, tell me, what a price, what a great price. Ye are bought, what a price, because of the price that brought you into the kingdom. That's why you're willing to pay any price. You will keep your place in the kingdom in Jesus' name. Hey, look at that again, verse 20. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Glorify God in your body. Pastor, tell me, how do I glorify God in my body? Your hand, part of your body, you'll never write anything, sign anything that will not glorify God. Your feet, part of your body, you'll never use your feet and walk anywhere, drive anywhere, that will not bring glory to God. Your eyes, you'll never see anything. You'll never be interested in anything. The people of the world, they are, you know, excited about that thing, masquerades. And they are running after old men and old women and young adults, men and women. Masquerade has come. And they are running after. Your feet will not follow them. Give me a good amen. Your eyes will not see them. No. All those dirty things they show on the screen of any gadget, your eyes will not see them. You know, you're looking for something on the internet, a And then something pops up and it says, follow this. No, I'm following Christ. I'll not follow that. I said, I'm following Christ. Anybody following Christ there? I am following Christ. I am following Christ. I will not follow that thing. Psalm 4, I'm reading from verse 3. Psalm 4, and we're looking at verse 3. But know that the Lord has set apart him that is godly for himself, not for Satan, not for evil, not for pollution, not for corruption. He has set apart him that is godly for himself. The Lord will hear when I call unto him. Somebody shout, amen. He set apart everyone that is godly for himself. We're looking at Revelation chapter 4. Revelation chapter 4. I'm reading from verse 11. Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. We've read in the Old Testament, he set apart him that is godly for himself. And now New Testament, Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power. For thou hast created all things, look at this, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. For thy pleasure they are and were created. Point number 3, benefiting from the old privileges as new peculiar people. Again, we're coming from the old to the new. And we're pointing out that all the good things the Lord has taught us in this old year, as we go to the new year, those good things abide. Those righteous standards abide. And those peculiarities abide. And we're not going to say it's a new year, therefore it's going to be a year of carelessness. It's going to be a year of sinfulness. No, we're peculiar people, peculiar in the old, peculiar in the new. Come to Exodus chapter 19. Exodus chapter 19. I'm reading here from verse 5. Exodus chapter 19, verse 5. Now therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed, and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine, and ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests and an holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel. And Moses came and called up for the elders of the people and laid before their faces all these words which the Lord commanded him. And all the people answered together and said, everybody, 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go again. 1, 2, 3, once again. All that the Lord has spoken, we will do. That's how to be a peculiar treasure, peculiar people. You see those Old Testament people, peculiar people. Let's come to 1 Peter chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2. Reading from verse 9. Peculiar treasure, peculiar people in the old, peculiar people too in the new. We're not supposed to be common. We're not supposed to be ordinary. Look at, you know, he says as a Christian, I can't see any peculiarity in his life. It's a Christian walking in any office, you cannot see the peculiarity of punctuality, the peculiarity of signing the exact time that she came to the office is going to sign another time. Peculiarity. Other people are claiming, overtime, which they didn't do. Peculiarity in his life is just like the same. He's a Christian in a family, and this one, the family got married that way, this one, the family. When he's going to get married, he marries in the same way. You cannot see any peculiarity if you're a child of God. The Lord said in the old, you are a peculiar treasure unto me. You'll be different, you'll be distinct. What the other people wear, you wear the same. How the other people go, you go the same path. What's the peculiarity? All your family members, this is what you do, and you are never different. What is the peculiarity? In the old, the people of God were peculiar. Come to the new, in the new, we're peculiar. And thank God I am peculiar. I said I am peculiar. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation. Tell me what follows. A peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You will be peculiar. Come back. Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19. If ye be willing and obedient, are you there? If ye be willing and obedient, I said, are you there? You know, in the past, we used to run to the Bible study. That time, I remember, we had only one Bible study in Lagos State. And people from Ekpe, they will come Monday night. From Ikrodu, they will come Monday night. From Badagry, they will come Monday night. And if the holdup delayed them as they got down from the bus and they looked at their time and they said crosses were started, they start running. How many of you remember those days? Those days are coming back again. You will enjoy hearing the word of God. You'll be willing hearing the word of God. It will not be for bread and butter. You will seek the kingdom of God first and his righteousness, and you give God chance to add all other things unto you in Jesus' name. If you be willing and eat the good of the land, and one of the people that will eat the good of this land, I said, I am. I said, I am. I said, I am one of the people that will eat the good of the land in Jesus' name. Famine will never get to your house. Poverty will never get to your house. Willing, willing, willing. What are we expecting now for the new year? Come to 2 Peter. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, according as his divine power, he has given unto us, how many things? All things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue this year. Glory this year, divine goodness this year, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that's in the world through lust. Every bad thing in your community, you'll escape. Every hazard, Every danger in your community, you will escape. The promises of God will be yes and amen in your life in Jesus' name. And I now usher you to the new year with the promises of God. Before you, the promises of God. Behind you, the promises of God. On your left, the promises of God. On your right, the promises of God. As you go, the power of God will go with you. The presence of God will go with you. And the sufficiency of God will go with you. No evil will come your way. The devil will fall before you in Jesus' name. As your days are, so will your strength be. Deuteronomy chapter 33. Deuteronomy chapter 33. I'm reading from verse 25. Thy shoes will be iron and brass. As thy days, so shall thy strength be. There is none like unto the God of Jeshur, who rideth upon the heaven in thy hill, and in his excellency on the sky. The eternal God is your refuge. Underneath you are the everlasting arms. He shall thrust out the enemy from before you, and shall say, destroy them. Israel, the people of God here today, shall dwell in safety alone. The fountain of Jacob shall be upon a land of corn and wine. Also your heavens shall drop down dew. Happy art thou. Happy art thou. Happy art thou. Who is like unto thee, O people, saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help? Who is the sword of thy excellency? Thine enemies shall be found liars unto thee. Thou shalt tread upon their high places. This coming year, you'll go higher. You'll be the head. You'll not be the tail. You'll be in front. You'll not be at the back. Progress. Peace. Prosperity. Healing. Health. Deliverance. Dominion. Miracles upon miracles all over your life. Rise up and receive. Rise up and receive. Rise up and receive. This your time, this your time. That time of refreshing. That session of refreshing. That season of refreshing. The beginning right now. Right now. Right now. Tell the Lord open your mouth. What do you want? Why have you come? Of the promises the Lord has made, which one are you claiming today? Which one are you receiving today? Multiplication. Abundance in your life, grace in your life, mercy in your life, forgiveness, salvation, freedom, liberty, liberation, the breaking of yoke, everything. He loves you and he says, I'm not going to leave you until I have done that which I told you all. Expect his blessing. Express your faith. That Lord, I know a faithful God. As you said, you will do. And you said the better time has come. I believe. I receive. Season of refreshing. season of multiplied blessing.
Yes, my beloved brethren.